So, yeah. So 90s grunge to me is more like drained down colors. Like, if you are gonna add some color, then it should be a little bit darker. 90s also has a little bit of, like, I guess. So some of my outfits have like shoulder pad-ish, or like they would be bigger on the shoulders, I guess, if that makes sense. Cause you know the power suit that was in the 80s might be a little bit carried down to the 90s, so I thought that that would be a good thing. Also, studs and black is a great thing in like 90s grunge. So I have all the pieces of clothing right here, on my bed, like hung up. It just looks kind of funny, but yeah, let's just start already because I'm taking too long. Okay, so the first outfit should be this one. So we're gonna start with something simple. So a dress like this, it's collared. And it's got a floral print, kind of. Little flowers on them, if you can see that. Yeah, like that. It has buttons right here. It's a little bit low on me, here, so I just like to add a little white tank top underneath that is fitted. What I would prefer wearing is a white tank top that's laced around here, because I think it just adds more to the outfit, because the lace makes it more fancier, I think, or prettier. And yeah, I don't have a lace tank top like this that's white or black or gray or any drained down colors like that. So I wish I did, but if you do have that, it would be really cute with something like this. So with this dress, you can wear a lot of sweaters. Like, you can wear this, something like this, maybe tie it around right here, if that makes sense. Or you could wear what I prefer is wearing it with this sweater, because I absolutely love this sweater. It's kind of a grandma-ish sweater, which I think kind of is what like ladies 90s grunge kind is. I think it's very grandma-ish with the floral print and the big sweaters. Like this dress, I think it's I got it because I like Gwen Stefani's outfit in the Don't Speak music video. The big polka dot dress, I think that was really pretty, and I thought this dress kind of represented it a lot, so I really wanted to get it so I could look like her, because Gwen Stefani is so amazing. That's what most of these outfits are inspired by. The shoes that could go with this are Converse, are a really big thing with the 90s grunge, I think. I wear this with any outfit that I consider 90s grunge. I think it has the grunge part of it. This is also some any color, like drained down, because I like this, would be good. You can also wear Mary Janes. These are the only pair of Mary Janes that I have. But I do want to get one that isn't such a big platform. These are the only ones I have, though. So yeah, you could wear that with that dress, or you could wear, if it's raining, you could wear a raincoat like this. You see those colors? That's how I want. That's how most of the outfits are, the colors are. And this one could go too for, you know, grandma-ish. So yeah, with that dress, that would be a cute outfit. Next outfit would be this white dress. If you've been on like the alternative kind of side of Pinterest, then you have probably seen the white dress girl. I got this dress because I wanted to be the white dress girl, and I think it's such a lovely dress. I think it's so pretty and flowy. I like it a lot. But this one I like to wear as my black Converse for a grunge type, and yeah, they're a little bit old Converse, so they kind of give off that grunge look, you know, the dirtier look. And this one could also go, kind of gives off a dolly look, I guess. And these could go for more of like a, I don't know, vintage look, maybe, I guess. So you can wear jackets like, you can wear these with that dress. You can wear something like this with the dress, or you could wear or you can wear this sweater that I showed earlier, but let me show you how you could wear it. Like with the dress, you could wear it tied up like this over the dress. I think it looks kind of cool. Kind of gives off a fairy, I guess, a fairy vibe. Yeah, you can wear that, but I've already shown this sweater a lot. This one, because this one is like what I add with every one of my 90s grunge outfits. So I thought it just brings out the grandma in it, I guess. I think it's really cute. So I'm gonna leave it here because I've used it a lot in the video. So another thing is overall dresses like this. I think they give off kind of like, I don't know, maybe they give off a playful vibe, like a tomboy girl. They go with this shirt, I think. You can wear it with this shirt, and you can wear your Converse with it. Any color, I guess. These as well. I don't think that the Mary Jeans would go with it, but I think those would kind of be a little bit ugly. So, yeah. You can wear it with any sweater, but that one could go with, I think that one could go with this favorite doll. Our favorite sweater. It's good to have a plain sweater like that. Because it's just a staple in 90s grunge outfits, I think. So yeah. You could also wear this with the overalls. That would look cute for a more fitted look, like baggy pants kind of. Or you could wear this one that I love. I love this one because you can see it has, I don't know if you can see, but it has a little bit embroidery right there, and it's cute, but once you took it in, it's better, trust me. It looks really baggy right now, but once you took it in, it's much better. It's kind of like a sweater material, by the way, so yeah. You could wear that raincoat. This one would look cute with that, and yeah. So the next outfit would be, I think, jeans. The baggy jeans again. So some baggy jeans like these. I got these at Maurice's. It's kind of expensive there, but these jeans, some boot cuts, I think would look really cute with this shirt. Probably more low-way, a V-neck. and, you know, a lace tank top or lace bra underneath. So that would be cute. And you could wear this outfit with, probably with, the black Converse. And I think, obviously these would go, but these might go, actually. I'm not too sure, but yeah. Some jackets that could go with it would be this. This one would go really cute with that outfit. And another shirt that could go with that. Oops. I'll get that. Another shirt that could go with that would be this sweater. We could also go with the jacket, corduroy jacket. This shirt that I have, I don't know why it's inside out like this, hold up. this shirt that I have could also go with the jeans. They would go with it because it's floral. And it's, yeah. Some belts that you could wear with it would be a nice studded belt. It kind of adds a little bit more to the outfit since it's such a kind of plain outfit. You can wear this belt. I think it's called a grommet belt. I'm not sure. But this one. And another jacket that you could wear, you can wear this one because I don't know, if you just want to be baggy that day, then you can wear just nice, big, baggy, navy hoodie that could go with it really well. Another shirt that you can wear with that would be this one. With those jeans would be this one, because this one's kind of tighter for a small shirt, big pants look. I think it would look cute. And you could layer this over this one. This one doesn't fit me, it's my dad's, but I think if you had one that fit you, then it would look cute. So yeah. Another outfit would be probably, oh wait, by the way, this shirt could go with your jeans a lot. It could go with the hoodie and the jeans. It's a cool little metal t-shirt. Metal band t-shirt that my brother got me. It's nice. Or gave me. So next outfit could be, so this long skirt. You could wear this long skirt to give up. I don't know. You could make it smaller by like probably to the knees. Really would be cuter, I think. But you can wear this skirt with, you could wear it with this one again. Your size, obviously. And you could also wear this shirt with it, the floral shirt. And you could wear a sweater like this with it to give off, I guess, kind of a homeless look, is what I'm saying. Most of these outfits. I think that's it for that one. But you can wear this as the, you can wear it tied or untied. It would be really cute either way, I think. And yeah. So another outfit I have. Oh wait, by the way, with that outfit, you could wear these. Or these. But mostly these, I think, would go with it really cutely. Another outfit would be with these flare jeans that I have. I think they're really cute. I think they're cute. But they're a beige color if you can't see the color. Well, and those could go with these. This nice shirt. I think it really gives off like a 90s kind of power suit, I guess. That's what I'm thinking when I see it. You could wear this one, which also, this outfit I feel like Rory Gilmore from Gilmore Girls would wear. This with the beige flare jeans would be cute. Maybe if it was a little bit more fitted, I think I would wear it more with the jeans. But it's cute to add more color to the 90s grunge. You could wear these, the fitted one, or the loose sweater. Oh, and by the way, another outfit was the big long black skirt is this. This would go really cutely tucked in or left out, and it would go cute with either of the Converse. I think that would be really cute. This could go with the beige jeans to give off a 70s vibe. I know we're not doing 70s, but it would be really cute with the jeans. This one, I really love this shirt because it's really fitted and it's really low, so you could wear it like with the white tank top underneath and it would still look cute. And you could probably, it would be a little bit 2000s too, sorry. But is that? No, that's not it. Sorry. Another outfit would be, oops. Sorry. Another outfit would be these black shorts. And the black shorts would be really cute with this shirt and this sweater. This sweater could also go with the jeans outfit, and it would also go with the long skirt outfit and the beige jeans outfit as well. And it would go with these, with the black shorts outfit, sorry. Also, what was I gonna say as well? Oh yeah, was the beige jeans, you could wear the studded veil, either of these. And you can also wear this one. This shirt, this sweater could go with this. And yeah. Another outfit would be another outfit would be these denim shorts, jean shorts, and they would go really cute with, they would give off more of like a 90s kid vibe, I guess. It would go with this shirt. It would also go with this sweater. It's a little bit more colorful sweater, and it also gives off more of the colorful 90s rather than just the Kurt Cobain 90s, I guess. Those shorts could also go with this jacket and this shirt. And it would look great with this shirt and this
these tank tops underneath the shirt.
And I think that was the last outfit. Sorry if I missed anything in this video. If you think something else would also go with would also go. I'm forgetting my words. Sorry. Oh, and this could go with some of the outfits and the jean shorts, baggy pants. This would go with all of them. Anyway. So, yeah. Let me check if there's anything that I didn't use in this video. No, I don't think so, but did I already say, I don't know, but this shirt would go with the jean shorts. So, yeah. And with the jean shorts, these would go with them. And so would this hoodie. The navy hoodie. So yeah, guys. Oh wait. With the jean shorts. These would also go. See ya. By the way, guys. So, in conclusion, the staples in 90s grunge outfits would probably be white dresses, anything, just plain white dress like this, grandma sweaters, just like this, would be really cute, and by the way, as you can see on the sweater, they have a little bit of more color in them. So it's not just like cream color. Another staple is sweaters like this, because they kind of poof out. They kind of poof out and then they cuff at the wrist and at your hips, like, or where the shirt ends. I think they would go really cute with like baggy jeans. And what else? Oh yeah, floral print is a big yes. And collared dresses as well, so that would be really cute. What else? Is that it? Oh yeah, by the way, always have colors like black, gray, forest green like this, moss green, cream, what else? And if you're gonna actually wear color, make sure it's a little bit darker. They're more darker colors, like. Also, have Converse. Converse are a big thing. High tops or not, Converse are huge. Always have Converse. Always have these too, because they also go with outfits. Like, so. I think they're really cute. And they go with baggy jeans, dresses. And they give off, they also go with the grandma sweater as grandma shoes. So yeah, flare jeans and boot cut jeans are also really cute. Beige colors as well. And where I live, it's really hot, so like tank tops are also really good. Fitted shirts as well. And long skirts like this that are maybe to your knees or to your ankles probably would be really cute. I think they go off more homeless-ish, which is kind of what the grunge is inspired by, I guess. And low-cut shirts so that you can wear a white tank top underneath is really, really cute. So, Yeah, I think that's the end of my video. Oh, one more thing. Subscribe if you want. Like if you want. Dislike if you want. Whatever you want, okay? Do any of those. And these type of belts, studded or grommet, are very, very good, I think. They go really well. They add a little bit of more flair to your outfits, and I think they're kind of a pop, considering all the drained colors. So, yeah. That's the end of my video. Hope you guys liked it. I should be able to list most of the things and where I got them from. Most of my outfits or clothing pieces that I used in this video and where I got them from in the description. If I don't, then I probably can't figure out where I got them or what brand they're from. So yeah. Bye. Watch the next video when I post it. So yeah, bye. Sorry if I wasn't looking in the camera the whole time. I'm used to the camera being over there, but I'm also used to looking at myself in here. This, like when you see yourself, because I'm filming on an iPad. So yeah, sorry if this video is a little bit quiet. I forgot to speak up. I don't know why. I forgot to speak up. And yeah. Hope you like the video. Hope you like the new microphone. And bye.